بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Investigations for carcinoma of the stomach. As usual, the most important investigation in MCQ for any GIT malignancy is endoscopy and biopsy. This is diagnostic and the most important. But as we know, we think first about non-invasive laboratory technique. In all GIT tumors, there is occult blood in stool. Blood picture, in all GIT tumors, there is microcytic hypochromic anemia. But in carcinoma of stomach, there may be also macrocytic hyperchromic anemia. The macrocytic anemia due to pernicious anemia, which is very common association with atrophic gastritis, achlorhydria, etc. Tumor marker, as all GIT tumor, CAA is a tumor marker, help to evaluate the response of the treatment and to follow up of the patient. Radiologically, barium meal, which is rarely not done nowadays because it's replaced by gastroscopy, therefore there is no need for barium meal. But if barium meal is done, it will show one of the following. May show irregular filling defect if the tumor is proliferative type. If the tumor is ulcerative type, large ulcer outside the ulcer bearing area. Carmen meniscus sign. Ulcer surrounded by a filling defect. This filling defect is a swelling, and this is a swelling around the ulcer, which is the elevated, everted edge of the tumor. There may be evidence of malignant pyloric stenosis. Malignant pyloric stenosis is irregular with mild proximal dilatation. In benign pyloric stenosis occur a long duration in benign pyloric stenosis due to fibrosed peptic ulcer. Duration allow huge proximal dilatation in benign pyloric stenosis, but this is a malignant pyloric stenosis occur rapidly, leading to mild proximal dilatation. If carcinoma in the fundus, to see this tumor, the barium meal should be done in Trendelenburg position. So that during taking X-ray, the head should be below and the lower limb should be above, so that the barium fall in the fundus to see the irregular filling defect of carcinoma of the fundus. Or in barium meal, there may be a narrow, irregular stomach. The stomach is converted to a narrow, irregular tube, which is linitis bilastica. Like this. This is a narrow, irregular tube in barium meal. Linitis bilastica. Beside barium meal, CT scan, upper abdomen. In CT scan, upper abdomen, this is the CT scan, upper abdomen. And the stomach has a diffuse second wall. Diffuse thickening of the whole wall of the stomach along its lens is a feature of linitis bilastica in CT. Therefore, CT upper abdomen show the local infiltration of the tumor and may show linitis bilastica like this. And this is the tumor and its extension locally. It is clear that the tumor is fixed to the surround the structure and the frame. Beside the CT scan and Baryon mill is rarely done nowadays. Ultrasound, chest and abdomen, very important to show lymph node enlargement. Endoscopic ultrasound, very important to show the local extent and the depth of invasion of the tumor. Plus, it show also enlargement of lymph nodes. Accurate staging locally and distally by PET CT scan and the PET CT to show the site of malignant cells. Diagnostic laparoscopy and biopsies from the suspicious area, like any peritoneal nodule or any liver nodule. Investigations detect metastasis as usual, Billing X-ray, chest, abdomen, bone, skull, for lung, brain metastasis from any suspicious area or any suspicious symptoms. Billing X-ray, ultrasound, chest and abdomen may show lung metastasis, lymph node enlargement, distal lymph node enlargement, enlargement of Virchow's gland, CT scan and the MRI for bone, brain, chest, abdomen. Radioactive isotope scanning mean any suspicious metastasis. Patient complaining of cough, we can do lung scan. Or patient complaining of jaundice, liver or ultrasound. Liver scan or ultrasound also detect the metastases. Bone and brain radioactive isotope scanning also discover all these metastases. PET scan discover all metastases all over the body. Finally, local staging accurately can be done also by diagnostic laparoscopy and biopsy if needed. What is the prognosis of the patient with carcinoma of the stomach? Depends on the stage of diagnosis. Depend up on degree of differentiation, depth of infiltration. If there is muscle spread, this carrying a poor prognosis, because once muscle spread, as we said before in the pathology, the muscles rich in lymphatics and the blood vessels, and this is the usual the depths of invasion with associated with blood and lymph node metastases. The 5-year survival rate in carcinoma of stomach is slightly better than carcinoma of the pancreas and the carcinoma of the esophagus. Carcinoma of the pancreas and the esophagus, the 5-year survival rate is 5% of patient. 5-year survival rate, 5%. But in carcinoma of the stomach, slightly better. It is about 10 to 20% 5-year survival rate. This is the investigations and